We are beginning tonight with some new predictions for a major earthquake in Northern California. A newly released study finds four California faults, the Hayward, Rogers Creek, Green Valley, and Calaveras faults, are all loaded and have enough tension to start a 6.8 earthquake or higher. All four of the faults are part of the San Andreas system that runs through both Hollister and San Juan Bautista. Scientists believe the fault lines could deliver major quakes in the next 30 years. Action News reporter Bryn Whitaker is live with more on how people are living on the fault line.
Well, I'm here in San Juan Bautista, right on the edge of the San Andreas fault line, the fault system that is really building up tension. And as we spoke to people around town today, they don't seem too concerned about this looming earthquake.
You never know when something's going to happen, and you can be prepared at home, but you just carry on with your life.
Nothing I can do to prevent it, except move somewhere where they don't have earthquakes, and I don't want to move, so I'm here till I die.
The San Andreas Fault System is the dividing line that marks where the western half of California shifts northwest, away from the rest of North America at about 2 inches a year. Over time, the faults that run through San Juan Bautista and Hollister build up tension. So scientists are predicting a big quake. In San Juan Bautista, the mission sits right on the fault line. The priest at the mission says the church needs to be retrofitted to survive a large quake.
So we make it as safe as possible for people to be here and to be present here and to gather here and to celebrate here.
But people around town aren't too concerned, even as they remember what it was like to be here for 1989's Loma Prieta earthquake.
It shook bad. Didn't last very long. If it lasted a long time, half these buildings would be gone.
It was pretty scary. It was the worst one that I've ever been in.
It is a coincidence that this study comes out just as California marks the 25th anniversary of Loma Prieta. Now, I did want to show you this fault line isn't just a gaping hole in the earth. It really is just a steep hill with sort of a ridge-like edge. And it really does show that these two tectonic plates are just going up against each other to create a hill. Just thought that was interesting to show people. Dan, back to you.
All right. Well, you really can't see a whole lot when it comes to the fault line, except in certain areas along the San Andreas Fault. For example, take a look at the DeRose Winery. It literally, and we've shown it to you before, it literally straddles the San Andreas Fault line, and it is literally pulling that building at DeRose Winery apart. The floors are crumbling. The walls bulge. There's a culvert that was actually once a straight line and now runs askew. U.S. Geological Survey has instruments there. They check them all the time. Managers at DeRose say sooner or later they're probably going to have to retrofit. By the way, this Friday marks the 25th anniversary of the Loma Prieta earthquake. We have dedicated an entire section of our website to it. You can watch and read Action News video and stories from our coverage on that day. You can find it on your computer or mobile device, all at ksbw.com.